Kiranya ada soalan nak tanya, inilah masanya.
Video ni akan post kat YouTube semua dari awal
tadi. Yes, you video ni akan keluar di YouTube dalam bahagian-bahagian ya. Okay. Dia akan ada satu CD keluar, insyaAllah. And then ada beberapa bahagian yang akan diedit supaya kita boleh letakkan di YouTube. Bila benda tu keluar, give them time to do their work. Thank you. Lain soalan? If you have a question to ask, this would be a good time to ask the question. Orang lain bayar saya RM500 satu soalan kalau nak bertanya. So, if you guys don't ask question, rugi gila. Dahlah rugi, gila. So, come on. Nanti cerita CD kemudian. Lain? About anything? Yes. Okay, how are we ever going to spend time with family or do other things if our time is always filled with, to do something, kan? Yeah. Remember yang kita buat tadi, when we did goals, and saya pecahkan self, family, career, organisation, kena lebih kurang, did that, kan? That's how you treat life lah. You put it into segments. Okay, I'm going to spend this much time for this segment, then you focus on that. You finish that, okay, and then I'm going to do this pula. You break things, you decide. There's no such thing as time management. Can you stop time?
No.
No, you cannot. But you can manage work. So you say, okay, this much work, I'm going to do this. This much, I'm going to play video games. This much, I'm going to go shopping. This much, I'm going to eat ice cream. You know what I mean? You decide. So it's your choice. It's your life. Can you copy other people? Can, but why do you want to copy anybody?
Yeah?
Look at me. I used to wear baju Kung Fu China. I had 95 pairs. Different colours, different design. Why? Because I wanted to be different. Waktu-waktu tak famous dulu kan. Sekarang famous, tak payah. Sekarang bila orang nampak macam Steve Jobs. Yeah. You know, Apple. Yeah. Apple punya creator, Samsung punya creator. Kenal? Tak kenal? Tak. Apa benda, beli benda-benda murah tu. Okay, sama. Banyak terus. Lagi, question. Man. Yes.
How long
does it take to be able to? How fast or how long totally depends on you. Haji Rahim is a person who had 38 years of experience doing what he does. And now he wants to start doing this. So you mean, with his age and whatnot, he still wants to do it. Yeah? The youngest PLF that I've had is 17 years old. The eldest is 85. Have you seen on Facebook, there's this Datin by the name of Datin Hendon who is doing her PhD and she's like on tour ni with two computers in front and... Have you seen this lady? Yeah? Yeah. She is a PLF. And she come to my class to learn, to become like me. So again, how long, how short, totally depends on you. You decide. You want to, do it. Don't want, dah. How many of you noticed throughout the whole time, did I sit? Melainkan the time when I ask you for permission, yeah? But did I sit throughout? No. Why? Because I'm having fun. Will I get tired? Yes. Orang keluar je. Penat gila lah. But the thing is, it's my choice, kan? I love what I'm doing. I'm having fun. Tak rasa penatnya. Dah balik tu, all the fun gone. Penat lah tu. Tidur. See, so how long, how short, totally depends on who you want to be. When you want to be that person. You want to be that person now? Be that person now. You want to be later? You choose when. Okay? Thank you. Line. Yes?
How to be professional person?
Professional in bertentangan dengan emotional. Okay? So, what's professional, what's emotional? Professional doesn't mean... Let me give you these two words. Respond dengan react. Apa beza dia? Apa beza respond dengan react? React macam ni ya, react macam ni. Kita tengah jalan, cicak jatuh. Boom, kat sini. Itu react. Itu react. Respond macam ni tau. Cicak jatuh. Oh, cicak. Dia ada tomat ninah dia. Orang-orang macam ni tak ada tomat ninah. Dia, terus. Okay. So, orang yang professional adalah orang yang tomat ninah. They stop and respond professionally. Orang yang emotional, dia react. Dia melata. Jadi je, marah, sedih, macam-macam. I'm not saying marah sedih is wrong. Tak. You can. It's how you do it. Siapa yang kadang-kadang rasa marah? Kadang-kadang. Pernah tak orang cakap, uruskan marah anda? Manage your anger? No? Because it won't work anyway. Yeah? So, I'm going to teach you how to manage your patience. Would you want to learn how to manage your patience?
Yes.
Alright. Patient dalam bahasa Melayu apa dia? Dalam bahasa Arab? S-A-B-R. Sabar. Okay, ready? S. Sabar tu is an acronym by itself. Okay, so untuk uruskan sabar, use this acronym as your guideline. First step you do, S, shut up. S stands for what?
Shut up.
No, you kena ada attitude sikit when you say shut up. Pandang kawan sebelah, cakap, shut up. Oh, pusing kat dia. Now, when I say shut up, it means two things. Shut up your mouth and shut up the voices in your head. Remember the inside out people inside there? Eh? Yeah, okay. The reason kita pening kepala kerana is all these voices in your head tengah bergaduh sama sendiri. Okay. So how do you shut up the voices in your head? Sleep? No. Your mind doesn't sleep at night. No, it still keeps awake. Pasal tu kita bangun pening lagi. Yeah. Alright, this is it. Orang yang buat yoga, the way they focus on one thing is they will always repeat one word. Contohnya to have inner peace, and they repeat. And what happens? All the voices in the head shut up. Kita ni Allah, zikir Allah, 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 until all the voices in your head shut up. And you shut up until you can say something good about what's happening. Selagi you cannot say anything good about it, shut up. Keep quiet. Okay? So, S, step one. Shut up. A, acknowledge the situation. Now, how do you acknowledge the situation? Remember, kita belajar, whatever happens, it happened because Allah will it to happen. Yes or no? That's how you acknowledge. Kita sering lupa tu. Orang langgar kita boom, terus melata. Ni boom, alhamdulillah. You know what I mean? Respond and react. So acknowledge the situation. Say alhamdulillah. Things happen. Okay? Whatever happen, anything good or anything bad will happen. Ini namanya takdir. How you respond to how it happens, that's your choice. S, A, B. Break the pattern. Now Rasulullah kata, kalau you marah berdiri, what do you do? Duduk. Kalau masih duduk, masa marah lagi, what do you do?
Baring.
So you change your state. You change your physical, your mind will change sekali. Okay? Bila saya marah dulu-dulu, saya cari aiskrim. Dulu-dulu when I'm like angry gila kan, I pergi cari aiskrim lah. Now, how I eat aiskrim, you know how the degree of marah I am. So, kalau I boleh duduk dekat kursi, dekat table tu makan aiskrim macam ni, marah tu kira okey lagi. Tapi kalau I duduk tepi jalan, mencangkung makan aiskrim, then don't touch me that time. Itu dulu-dulu. How I manage. my anger. Okay. Sekarang, I cari tabung. So, contohnya, bila I marah kan, I pergi cari tabung. Kalau KFC kat situ, I pergi lah. Kat kaunter kan ada tabung KFC kat depannya. I mula masukkan duit. First, shilling first. Shilling, tengah marah ni, shilling. Asal masuk RM1, RM5, masuk 10, dia slow sikit. By the time reach 50, I'm a bit slow. Until I stop. And then I leave. Because I have to let it go. Kita marah, you keep it, dia makan dalam, betul? So, I let it go. Itu cara saya. Now, some of you, how many of you when you marah, you go and eat atau you go shopping? Put out your hands. Now, here's my suggestion here. If you want to eat, you buy food, but you give it to somebody else. Don't eat it for you. Because because if you eat it, bayangkan, and kau beli chocolate cake ni, aku tengah marah ni. So that marah goes in. You see what I mean? So that marah tu, you need to go out. You need to let it out. So bagi dia chocolate cake. Nah, aku pergi secret recipe ni, nak ambil kau cake. Kenapa kau ni? Aku tengah marah. Makan je lah. How many of you will go shopping? Put your hands. When you're angry, you go shopping. Alright, bayangkan. Aku marah ni. Tengok. Baju merah RM100, beli lah. And every time you see that baju merah in your closet, it will remind you of the day you marah. Yes lah? Apa gunanya? So nak beli baju merah tu, beli untuk orang. You buy, you give. You have to let it go. You have to break the pattern. Do something else. Okay? Are you following me?
Yes.
S, A, B, R. Now, you say redha. Now, redha to me is two things. Redha means to me, you learn from the situation, then you let go. You watch Frozen?
Yeah.
Yeah. Let it go. Don't sing. Do not sing the song. Please. You know how some people say forgive and forget?
Yes.
No such thing.
Yes.
No such thing. Yeah? You forgive and you let go. You cannot forget because everything good, you can remember, you're bound to remember everything bad. The thing is, kenapa Allah let you remember? Yes, as learning. So that's why you need to learn. Learn from the situation. As long as you cannot learn from the situation, you will never redha. You will never can let it go. So learn from the situation. Learn from it, and then let it go. If it comes back, it is because Allah said, you belum habis learning lagi. There's still some learning that you missed out. And you relearn. That's the fastest way to learn. Nabi Musa nak ikut Nabi Khidir. And then, ini dalam Quran kan? And then Nabi Khidir kata, not yet. Kau belum cukup ilmu. Kau belum cukup ilmu. Oleh kerana kau belum cukup ilmu, kau tak akan sabar. Tapi Nabi Musa nak ikut juga. Kan? So, here's the learning ya. You see, kita nak sabar, kena ada ilmu. The thing is, can we ever have all the ilmu in the world? No. So, to reach that point, you need to learn and learn. And learn. Whenever anything happens to you, you want to redha, learn from it, then let it go. That's how you redha. Puan Hayu, you there? All right. Thank you very much for the experience. When you see me again, senyum apa?
Tiga.
Tepuklah kawan. Now, after the closing that Puan Hayu wants to do,